this lecture, we are going to analyze the Olt-Winters forecasting method, also known as exponential smoothing with trend and seasonality. The forecast for future demand, FT plus 1, is based on the analysis and extrapolation of the time series of the past demand. In other words, given the time series of the demand, D1, D2, DT, at the end of period T, the forecast for the next period, T plus 1, is a function of the past demand. This method leverages on the idea of breaking down the demand into three components: the average, which is the base level, the trend, and the seasonal factors. If we are at the end of the period T, the forecast for the next period, FT plus 1, is equal to the average measured in T, AT, plus the trend measured in T, TT, all multiplied by the seasonal factor measured in period T plus 1 min L, where L is the seasonality. For example, if we have seasonality on an annual basis and each period is 1 month long, L is equal to 12 months. More in general, if we are at the end of period T and we need to forecast the demand in period T plus M, where M is the forecasting horizon, we can adapt this formula. Since the trend is referred to one single period, it should be multiplied by M. Moreover, we have to consider the right seasonal factor. How can we compute these three components, that is the average, the trend, and the seasonal factors? We have to distinguish two phases. The first application of the model, starting from the time series, and the update of these variables when new values of actual demand become available. In this lecture, we will see the first phase. Please refer to the next one for the second. So, let's start with the first application of the model, the so-called initialization. If we have the time series of the last 2 years, we can use these simplified formulas. The trend is equal to the average demand in the second year, that is the more recent one, minus the average demand in the first year, all divided by the number of periods per year, n. Then we can compute the initial value of the average component. A0 is equal to the average demand in the more recent year, year 2, plus the trend we have assessed before multiplied by the number of periods in 1 year divided by 2. We have assessed the initial values of the average and the trend. Now we have to assess the initial seasonal factors. It's not just one value, since we have to compute a seasonal factor for every period of the year. The seasonal factors can be computed comparing the actual demand with the average demand. For example, for the year number 1 of our time series, the seasonal factors can be computed dividing the actual demand in period I by the average demand in year 1. The same can be done for year 2. If we have 2 years, we can assess the seasonal factors by taking the average of the values computed for each period I in the last 2 years. After having computed all these values, we can apply the Olt-Winters method to forecast the future demand. Let's see an example. Let's consider the following time series of the past demand, and let's assume that we are at the end of December 2016. We assume seasonality on a yearly basis. We want to forecast the future demand by applying the Olt-Winters method. First of all, we have to initialize the model. Let's start with the trend. T0 is equal to the average in 2016 minus the average in 2015, all divided by n, where n is equal to 4, since we have 4 quarters for a year. The average demand in 2015 is equal to the total demand, 480, divided by the number of quarters, 4, so it's equal to 120 pieces. We do the same to compute the average demand in 2016, and we obtain 131.25 pieces. Therefore, the trend is equal to the difference between the two average values, all divided by 4, and we obtain a positive linear trend of 2.81 pieces per quarter. Now we can assess the average. We have to take the average of the more recent year, 2016, and to add the trend in n divided by 2 periods. Therefore, we obtain 136.87 pieces. As for the seasonality factors, let's start with the first quarter. We said we have to take the average of the seasonal factors computed in each year. As for 2015, we need to divide the demand of the first quarter, 100 pieces, for the average in 2015, 120 pieces, and we obtain 0.83. If we do the same for 2016, we obtain 0.88. Therefore, the initial seasonal factor for the first quarter is the average between 0.83 and 0.88, that is 0.855. In the same way, we can compute the other seasonal factors, and we obtain these values. Now, we can forecast the future demand using the old winters method. The forecast for the first quarter of 2017 is equal to the initial average 136.87 plus the trend 2.81, all multiplied by the seasonal factor of the first quarter 0.855, and we obtain 119.43 pieces. At the end of December 2016, we can be interested also in forecasting the demand in other quarters. For example, if we want to forecast the demand in the second quarter of 2017, we have to properly consider the trend and the seasonality factor. More specifically, we have to consider two times the trend, one the first quarter, another one for the second quarter, and the seasonality factor of the second quarter. If we do so, we obtain around 136.08 pieces. In this lecture, we have seen how the old winters method can be used to forecast future demand. More specifically, we have seen how to initialize the model and how to perform the forecastings. In the next lecture, we will see how to update the variables of the model, that is the average, the trend, and the seasonality factors, when new values of demand become available.